Hey guys, I'm Hyman with Engineered Comfort, Heating, Venting, and Air Conditioning out of Fort Worth, Texas. And today what we're gonna do is replace the motherboard on this here Gree heat pump mini split. It's a very difficult process, takes a lot of patience and a lot of precision, but it's fairly easy if you just, like I said, take your time. So first things we wanna do is disconnect the power, because this is a 230 volt unit and it will electrocute you. Won't look good on your report. So let's start with that. Disconnect the disconnect. This will ensure you there's no power, but even before you start, you always gonna wanna double check with some type of voltmeter or a electrical pin or something like that, okay? There's gonna be screws, Phillips head screws all the way on the top. You're gonna wanna start by taking those off. So let's start doing that.
Okay, so those are the screws there, all the way on the top. Goes all the way around the unit, and there's a few down there at the bottom. Okay, I'm gonna take all those screws off to get this front panel right here off so we can access the motherboard.
I'm actually going to be using a drill with a Phillips head chuck on it, just to make it a little faster, because it is a little chilly out here. Make sure you don't lose any of the screws. Put them in a safe spot. Once you removed all the top screws, you're going to be able to take that top panel off. I carry a little bag to put the screws in there so I don't lose them. I recommend you do the same thing. Alright, top comes off. Not as easy as it seems. Here's where the motherboard is, where you're gonna have to access to it. So first things first, we're gonna have to remove this panel, and you got a screw here, screw here, screw here, and a screw down at, two screws down at the bottom, and that's pretty much it. Let's take those off. Once you remove those screws, you're going to want to lift up and pull out. This side, same way. Lift up, pull out. And this whole panel comes off. Set that off to the side. Here's the motherboard that you're going to be accessing. So you got a screw inside here under the cables, and you got a screw on this side to remove the top plate to get that off to get access to the board. Let's do that. It's good to have a little magnet or something on hand to get to these little screws so you don't lose them. Got that off. Gonna want to get a flathead screwdriver, stick it in on the side where the tabs are, and just gently lift up on it. Not too hard, be careful not to break the tabs. And then the board cover should come right off. Set that off to the side. Here's the board. Let's take a look at that. That's the motherboard that we're gonna be replacing right there. Gotta be careful with all those connections. Let's get to it.
All right guys,
cover and you've removed the top and you've removed this top, then you're going to want to get a screwdriver. You don't want to mess with the drill on this part, because you're going to have four screws right here holding this board down and one big one in the main one. So then you're going to want to take these screws off. Okay. Move these off to the side, and this will pop up the board for you. So that way you don't have to remove all this wiring and all these really, really complicated fixtures. Okay, so let's do that. Be careful not to lose the little washers that are on the screw, because you're going to need that to hold the board in place. Okay, so once you've removed all the screws, the one in the middle, set them off to the side. Let's lift that board up. Be very careful. It has a heat shield adhesive on it that holds it down. Okay, so you're going to want to see what's holding your board in there. And once you got your board up, then you can start doing your disconnects. They have these little connection holders that you got to remove. Oops. After there, before you can actually disconnect the board. Okay, so you want to make sure that you got all those off, so you can disconnect all your plugs, and try not to lose them, because you're going to need them to put them back. One fell here. I'm going to have to get to the front of this, to the power source. That's what starts that. In here, which is going through there, cut that dill off. We've got a little dill here holding that on there. All right, so you're gonna have here white, gray, and blue wires, or actually white, gray, and black. Okay. So, find your plugs over here, white, gray, and your black. What I would recommend is get your cell phone out and take a picture of it, so you don't forget how it goes back. And that's exactly what I'm going to do right now. White, blue, black is on number two. Okay, so go ahead and get a little flathead and just pop those off. Get that out. So now, board is out of there. Now we can take this motherboard and replace this bad boy and hopefully get this homeowner going with no more problems. Stay tuned for reinstalling the board. Let's go get our board, everybody, and replace this bad boy. Woo! think about it. Just think about it. Lately I've been skeptical, silent when I would use to speak, distant from all around me, who witness me fail and become weak. Life is overwhelming, heavy is the head that wears the crown. I'd love to be the one to disappoint you when I don't fall down. But you don't understand when I'm attempting to explain, because you know it all and I guess things will never change.
The new board, and let's just start connecting it back. This is the old board, one's no good. Move it off to the side, and let's start making our connections. First things first, I always like to start with the ones that are hardest to do. So get all your wiring inside first, and like I said, start with the ones that are hardest to do. Said brown was on top on the ACO, so let's put that on there first. Okay, and then start making the rest of the connections. You pretty much just want to make sure that you make all the connections properly and make every single connection. So pretty much each pigtail will only fit in its own pigtail, so you cannot connect it with the wrong wire. Just make sure that it fits and snaps on properly, and you'll be good to go. Make sure every single one of the wires are correct and that this board sets the way that it's supposed to in its housing. Very important. Okay, so before we anchor it down, looks like road.
Once you've made all your connections and you've put all the screws back in there, those screws and the screw that's actually holding your board down, and you made all your connections back correctly and all the connections back on your board, now you're ready to connect your power wire back to these connections.
You just kind of want to make sure to put the board cover back on and all the screws before you put the sides on. All right, once we've done that, we can go on ahead and put the power
we're back on. I'm not going to need to access this anymore. So once you got your power top on, then now it's time to slide in the side cover, which we've got over here. And the way I do it is you have these little lips right here that will, there's three of them, that will slide into the grooves in here. So I want to just slide them in there first and then go to the other side. And same thing on the other side. Flip them up, slide them in there. Push down and you should be good to go. Shouldn't have any screws left over. All right, guys, let's put the power back on, turn it on, and see what we get. And that, my friends, is how you successfully change a motherboard on a Gree heat pump mini split. Thanks for watching. Again, I'm Hyman with Engineered Comfort Heating, Venting, and Air Conditioning out of Fort Worth, Texas. And remember, we not only provide and protect your comfort, we engineer it.